I did walk in there with the camera in a different rather than you. So. You check that out. Here's deck six. Here is something very cool. First of all, we have all these, inaugural visit type things. And here's a ship model. I wouldn't mind having one of these in my house. It's gonna be expensive. And they do not sell this big. They do have mini ones. Here's some pictures of it being built. Alright. Not sure that I can go in dining rooms right now. But is it really in use for breakfast? Here's my explorer.
Il y a ceux qui font toute la journée, il y a ceux qui font une heure. Tu vois, c'est
un peu début. Yeah, I'm not sure if that's actually a real piano because I walked by one time and I heard a speaker inside of it playing piano music, so. Not sure. Let's see if we can walk in here to just taste. One of the dining rooms. They also have other ones, Thiever. Which I'll just kind of go up to the window here. It's pretty much the same, maybe a slightly different color theme. Maybe in there, electric piano. I don't even know if there's a real piano. This is the art gallery. Alright, we have Stephen Hawkey. They have, if you've never heard of Tabanyaki, you probably do. Yeah. The atrium. This is the Lustro. Specialty restaurant. We have Headliners, which is usually the comedy club, although on this island I don't look at being a comedy because we do have a lot of different languages on board. closed at the moment, but a little bump up. On the first day, they didn't use it as kind of a room where they would sell the drink packages. Here is the Patreon again. We have the bar. Guest services, short excursion.
That's the first choice. Second choice is the
butterfly display. Illusionarium. We have card room. And library. So this is the library. There's no one in here at the moment. It's a nice library. We have quite a few books for cruise ship libraries. The Ruby, I remember, didn't have barely anything in there. I think the Coral had stuff in there, though. So if you're into reading, and you have a lot of extra time, there's the place. This is the card room in there. I'm not going to go in there because there's people who probably don't really want to be videoed, but that's a nice area. We do have a really cool history wall here of the Norwegian Getaway and the Norwegian Cruise Line, and the Getaway Cruise Line and Port of Miami, where it's usually based. Norwegian sailed the first ship out of the new man-made island on Miami, which was the Sunward, back in the old days. We have Pacific Meeting Room and Atlantic Room. This picture is two Norwegian ships and three carnivals in Miami. That's the epic. This is a kind of a countdown of all the ships over the years. Something I think is interesting is it jumped straight from Escape to Bliss. It says Bliss 2017, and it's actually being made 2018. And Joy. This is the Getaway as it's being built again. Alright, we'll see you on deck 15. So this is what the elevator looks like. I went out to 15 and I realized I forgot to
video of the atrium going up the stairs. So I'm going to go do that real quick, and then we'll come back to 15. What's up the stairs? There is the stairs. At night they do change kind of like a multicolor. I like the green better. And that changes as well. Sometimes like a red, white, blue, or other colors. I really like how modern the ship is. It was built in 2014. Alright, so I'll see you on deck 15. I just walked by the sunset bar and I think they're meeting for a tour there. We have the Haven entrance here. You just get a new Haven card if you're in there. Part of booked with them. There is ping pong. They have two family hot tubs and two adult pool. And the bar. Then they have the kids' pool and the aqua. Like water slide. It's kind of split up, which is not very nice. To wash your hands. They have a soft serve cream. Self serve machine. They did put in a Margaritaville on this chip, which they charged for. So, I think there was something called Flamingo Blanco that used to be here that they didn't charge for, so not so great with that, but looks nice. They have a rock wall. And the ropes course, which we'll go up there in a minute. H2O, which is adults only until 7 p.m. Which, and at 7 p.m. everything is closed there, so almost pointless. That's okay, it's a nice area. There are a lot of things closed right now because everyone's supposed to be in port. The team club. They do have an arcade area. So when I try to do stuff with precision, I get shaky. So, doesn't help. There, so the plank's over there. We have a sports court. There is one zip line back there, and you have to do it to get off, so. And make sure you get off to a good start, like fast enough, because several people have got stuck in the middle. Because that would be scary. Then entrance to the ropes course. They also have a little children's one. They've got little children. That's very nice. This is St. Petersburg again. Five ships and more. My battery is getting low, so we're gonna try and hurry this up. Main pool deck again. They have these nice areas you can walk out on the bridge. So, it is an adult pool. If you're an adult, that's great. But I think they could use a bit more. Maybe another pool. The other one is kind of split in half. You can go to the front of the ship. The front is right up there. And it's only partway because we have the vibe. Which I'm gonna say is probably somewhere like the, which is somewhat like Princess's Sanctuary. Here's just a sun deck. These upper sun decks you never see chairs out on. You know, St. Petersburg has been one of the coldest ports in the Baltic, or places like Copenhagen, warm. This is vibe. You can kind of look down on it. Then we have the front here. It's interesting because it's like cold wind and all that, but then the sun beating down. You're half freezing and half boiling. So again, we're going to have the Miami theme on the painting stuff. Some random deck chairs, probably set up by guests. Maybe there's six ships in port. It looks like another celebrity. So, St. Petersburg, I think, is very big, which means they can accommodate more. I'm gonna guess at least 16,000 people, if not closer to 20,000. I'm just estimating. This one, our ship has 4,000 people. That has at least, probably has around 4. That one's probably 3. That's probably 3. This, 2 to 3. That one, under 1,000. That's a lot of people. Alright, deck 16. I'm gonna go see if I can like a peek in the chin. It's pretty busy. Not too much. Thank you for watching my ship tour of the Norwegian Getaway. Hope you enjoyed it.